Hello everyone, my name is Betül Durak from Microsoft Research, and today I'm going to talk about the construction of format preserving encryption. We named it as FAST. It's a joint work with Henning and Michael Horst from Comfort in Germany and Serge Vaudeney from EPFL. Format preserving encryption, or FPE in short, is essentially a deterministic block cipher. It encrypts a message from domain D to the same domain. And the domain is defined with the format. And in this slide, I'm showing an example of 4 digits. And the format is defined with the length of the message. In this case, it's 4. And with an alphabet. In this case, it's a set of digits. So it is Z10. But there could be some other formats that we may see, that we may observe in the real world in databases, such as social security numbers or credit card numbers, or even smaller domains, or a bit larger domains than this. So the idea in general is that when we would like to lift the security of a database by encrypting it, we would like to keep the format of the data which is encrypted because of transparency reasons. So when there is an encryption which keeps the format, there will be no need for applications to be rewritten, or no schema changes will require when the security is updated, lifted. So one way to think of the format preserving encryption is to use the traditional block ciphers like AES, because AES is strong. AES has been analyzed for a long time. It's very fast. It has made very fast, and it has everything we want. But then the problem would be the keeping the format in the ciphertext, because if we want to keep the format in the ciphertext, we need to truncate it, and then we cannot decrypt it back. Another idea could be to use the counter mode, because we won't need to decrypt back if we can truncate it as we want. But then it would require the encryption and decryption to sync and maintain a set of counters, which is not so pleasing. And instead, a big line of research has been proposing lots of different FPE constructions. The most notable ones are from NIST, which are standards now. They are called FF1 and FF3, and they are based on Feistel networks. And if you may remember, the Feistel networks are consisting of some rounds. And in the specific case of FF1 and FF3, the round functions are defined with the AES. And since the number of rounds are quite small for both cases, for both standards, it's practical. And the security has been already analyzed by many cryptographers. In our work, we designed a new format preserving encryption, which has a new taste, different taste. It still consists of rounds, but then the rounds are not traditionally defined with the AES round function. Instead, it is defined with several layers of permutation boxes, as we will detail in a short while. And where the secret keys are used is then in the setup, secure setup phase, we generate a pool of S-boxes that will be used in those layers. And these S-boxes will be generated with the AES. And our other contribution is that we analyze the security of such a construction. And we formally proved that we can reduce the security from strong security to weak security. And then it allowed us to analyze the cryptanalyze the scheme only in the weak model, with several different attacks that we instantiated. And then finally, we adjusted our parameters for the construction, such as number of layers, number of rounds, etc., with a security margin to protect, to provide good security. So before getting into the details of our construction, let me say a few things in general about the FPE. FPEs are generally are tweakable in the sense that because of the domain, domains are too small, there is a big probability that the ciphertext for the same message, there's a big probability that two different records in the database for corresponding to two different users will be having the same plain text, and they will encrypt to the same ciphertext in which it leaks. And therefore, we introduce a tweak. And this tweak essentially is very important for domain separation. And on top of that, which I don't show here, is that the FPE takes the format as part of the input as well. And it is desired to have it in the input. So I will show, I would like to show you here the two different instances, two different styles of format preserving encryption. On the left, we have the Feistel-based network, Feistel-based FPE. These are only toy examples. I didn't draw the entire FF1, FF3, or neither our construction. It is just for illustrating the purpose, the differences. On the left, we have a message. We have a Feistel-based FPE, and the message is divided into two halves, and these two halves are entering to the branches. And there is a round function, and each round is defined with the input with a key, secret key K, and a tweak. And tweak changes for each round. And on the other hand, we have a substitution network where we have the plain text, which has length L, and each character in the message is going to be a registers, and each of them will one by one entering to a substitution boxes. It's a substitution, essentially a substitution network. And in here, essentially the rounds on the Feistel-based constructions are defined with the secret key AES, with the secret key and the tweak. And in our case, there will be no secret keys and no AES computations. It will be only the substitution boxes of several layers, and AES will be used in the secure setup for key derivation. So the parameters that we have that I will need for the rest of this talk are as follows. The format, I already mentioned, is defined with the size of the alphabet, it is A, and the length of the messages. And in this case, we can imagine that the alphabet is ZA, it's a set of integers from 0 to A minus 1. And we also have another parameter called M, which is the total number of S boxes to choose. And essentially the S pool is generating M many S boxes. And in practice, typically we can think of this M as 256, because we will need the index of each of these S boxes when we want to use it in the layers. And it would be nice if we can represent them all with one byte. So this is what M is. R is the number of rounds, and N is the total number of layers. And N is set to L times R, because each round will consist of same number of layers. And because the message of the length of the message is L, then we see that N is equal to L times R. So what is important here is that how to pick the R. What would be the R for security? So that we will analyze in the paper and with cryptanalysis results. So the one instance that I can show you here is that the L is equal to 4, meaning that the message has length 4, and it has 3 rounds and 12 layers. So one example of round is this. It consists of 4 layers because the length of the message is L. And there is layer 10, which is essentially only the round operation and the substitution box that we show here. This probably explains what we mean with layer and round better. So let me get back to the setup phase, that where we use the secret key. The secret key, master secret key, is used for key derivation. And this key derivation works with the set of parameters, two different set of parameters. We separated these parameters because we wanted some flexibility, as I will describe shortly, that in the first set of parameters, we have only the length of the size of the alphabet and the M, the number of S boxes in the pool that we generate. In the second set of parameters, we have the L, N, and W1 and W2. I will not explain W1 and W2 yet, just yet. I will describe it with a picture in the following slides. Just assume that those are two different numbers, parameters. So what happens is that then the key S, we derive a key S from master secret key K, an instance one and only instance one with a constant. And this means that there will be this key S will be derived differently whenever the instance changes, instance one changes. It means that whenever the alphabet size changes, it will be computed, recomputed. But as long as there is no changes in the size of the pool and the size of the alphabet, this won't need to be computed again. And KeySec is going to be generated with the both instance one, instance two, as well as the trick. Let me explain a little more where they are used. This derived keys KS is going to be used to generate the pool of permutations, and KeySec is going to be used to generate the index sequence to which indices should be used for layers, for S boxes for each layer. So that means that when the tweak changes or the size of the message changes, L in instance two, then only the KeySec part needs to be regenerated. Only the index sequence needs to be regenerated. Other than that, we don't need to keep creating the pool of S boxes from scratch, as long as there is no changes in A, L, and M. So this was the property that we wanted. Therefore, I put a thumbs up here. And this is essentially our way of doing the domain separation. In the S box generation, more in a bit more detail, we have the input secret key KS. And this key S is used in the AES for PRNG. And this PRNG is instantiated with AES in counter mode. It's parallelizable, it's nice. And the permutations are generated with the Fisher-Yates shuffling. And the Fisher-Yates is essentially some sort of rejection sampling. It's simple enough. And SBox index sequence generation is again taking an input secret key KeySec and using the PRNG as well as some domain parameters. And then we instantiate this PRNG again in the implementation with AES in counter mode. But these two PRNGs in the SBox generation and the index sequence generation could be completely different. It's up to the implementer, but we chose AES in counter mode for parallelizable features. The core design that we have is that it is going to, I show you first with the one round with four layers. So it is four layers because we have four substitution boxes here. But I have been saying this since the beginning, but let me correct myself. Let me make it more precise, more correct. It is not essentially one S box that I'm using here. It is two S boxes, two same S boxes that we are using here. And there are two arrows, as you can see here. One is entering to the round operation. It looks like the round operation, but essentially entering input to the first S box, S1. And the second one is entering to the S box permutation, but it's essentially, again, entering to the S box, but the second S1. So in here, what we define this blue arrow and orange arrows are that they need to come from some registers here, and we wanted to define the distance of these registers to the S boxes. So in the first case, the input to the first S box is called W1, and the distance in this example is one, and the second distance to the second S box is called W2, and it is shown with an orange arrow here. The distance to the S box over here is two. And these parameters W1 and W2 are the same for all layers, as you can see here, except that sometimes they rotate because there is nothing on the left side of the X1 register, so it rotates, and also it keeps shifting. So if it starts from X4, but then it comes to X1 and X2 and X3 and so on. So this is the design for one round at a high level. If you wonder why we choose it this way, why we define it this way, it would be difficult for me to explain the reasoning in a few sentences. Instead, what I could say is that we essentially didn't start our design with just one S, with two S boxes like this one, but instead we defined something more like this without this W1 and W2. And we designed it in a way that the diffusion property will be sufficient for both encryption and decryption. But unfortunately, when we design it with only one S box and in a very simple manner, it would require a lot of number of rounds for diffusion to happen well for the decryption. Everything was fine for encryption, but for decryption it was difficult. And therefore, we tried several different versions of this construction, and we are convinced that this is resisting to our attacks, and this makes a number of rounds smaller and more practical, and yet secure enough. So this is the high-level intuition I could give you. And for the three rounds with four layers, again, we have the same round repeating three times, except that none of the S boxes that we use in the first round will be same in the second round. They won't be same, they will be different, and they will be picked from the with the AES computation in the index sequence generation. As of security, let me start with the assumption we have. We have the assumption that the adversary has access to the S pool. All the S boxes are known to the adversary, because it's a reasonable assumption, because it may leak from side channels, and we wanted to, we didn't want to assume any such leakage, but instead we want to be safely say that pool can be leaked. And then we defined a strong security model with multi-target chosen formativicable PRP. Essentially, the idea here is that there is an adversary playing with the encryption decryption machines. And each of these encryption decryption machines have different secret keys, so therefore there are it is called multi-target, and the adversary can also change the format or the tweak when she's querying these oracles, when she's playing with these machineries. In the weak security notion, the adversary is allowed to play again with the encryption decryption oracle, but it is only for one key. And then the adversary must fix the format and tweak once for all queries that he's making to this encryption decryption machinery. So this is the notions that we define. And we formally prove in the paper that there is a reduction from the strong security notion to the weak security. And a bit more formally, essentially, what we say is that there is a tau here. The tau is the number of different keys in multi-target game, and the Q is the number of queries that that has been done. And what we say here is that there are four adversaries A, B, C, D, and this we say that if the PRF, PRNG1 and PRNG2 are secure, and if the advantages of B, C, and D are negligible in the games that they play, then the strong security is going to reduce to the weak security. It means that if someone can give an attack in the strong model, then we can construct an attack in the weak model. And this is essentially the high-level idea of our proof. And this led us to, as I said earlier, to only focus on the weak model. We cryptanalyze the construction in this weak model, meaning that by fixing the key tweak and the format. And then according to our cryptanalysis results, whatever we found, we doubled the number of rounds for security margin. So little more details, not too much. We designed many different types of attacks, like distinguishers or linear differential or linear attacks and so on. All the details are in the paper, and you're welcome to try even more or improve those attacks if you want. That would be nice for us. But essentially the outcome of all those attacks is that we were able to define what the W1 and W2 would be. Because intuitively, when we first started discussing the design, then we would guess that this W1 and W2 would be naturally something like L over 2, the half of the length of the messages, or L over 3. But we wouldn't guess that it would be a square root of L. And then it can still be set to L over 2, W1 and W2 can still be set to L over 2, but then it would require asymptotically L square number of layers that we need to use in the construction to be secure. But if we pick W1 and W2 being around the square root of L, then the total number of layers asymptotically can be picked as L to the 3 half, and it would be enough. Asymptotically, again, there is a constant term that we multiply it, and in the small, when the parameters are small, it does not reflect well, but when the number of parameters get larger, it will be more visible that we need n equals to order of L to the 3 and 3 half. So in here, I show you one set of parameters, selection of parameters for a fixed, for number of rounds. And we have a different size of alphabets, and we have different length of messages. And L is the different lengths of messages from 2 to 100, and A is from 4 to 16, but you can find more parameters in the paper. So just to give an example, when we encrypt the full 16 digits of credit card numbers, the L would be 16 because the message length will be 16, and the alphabet size will be 10 because they are digits. We need 37 rounds of our construction. And we experimented our construction, and we compared it with the existing FF1 and FF3 for both constant tweak and changing tweak. The performance doesn't change for FF1 and FF3 if the tweak changes, but as I explained in the setup phase, if the tweak changes, we need to generate the sequence of indices again, and that would affect the performance. Therefore, we tested both, and we tested it for alphabet size being equal to 10. We observed that in all cases, our construction fast is faster than both FF1 and FF3. So maybe what is important here is that, like, probably it was known to many people who are implementing that. After the certain length of the messages, suppose 32, the characters of a message, there is a big jump in terms of complexity for FF1 and FF3. And this seems to be known to people who are implementing these designs. But in our case, there is no such blow up happens. The problem, the actually what happens here with the FF1 and FF3 is that because of the modulo reduction they have in the round functions. If you remember, the round functions are round operations are modulo operations, and the messages are divided by half, and therefore the modulo reduction happens with modulo a to the L over 2. And if L becomes larger and larger, there would be a significant performance problem with the big integer libraries that we are using to implement them. And that creates a problem for both FF1 and FF3. And FF3 is essentially does not recommend us to encrypt any messages larger than 54 or 56, I believe, but we just abused it and we encrypted up to 64. But FF3 does not actually provide larger message sizes. So this concludes my talk. Thank you very much for your attention and for listening to my talk. And we would like to welcome everyone, every cryptographer, everyone who is working on format preserving encryption or open to different designs to cryptanalyze our construction. The code is provided in this GitHub link. We also linked it in our paper. Please join us to cryptanalyze it further.